With us, Chef Jessie Sincioco, seasoned chef, teacher, and Filipino food advocate who runs and operates Chef Jessie's Top of the City and Rockwell Club. We have Chef Myrna Seguismundo, food writer, book author, restaurant managing director, and respected chef. She is behind Restaurant 9501 here in ABS-CBN and is the organizer as well of the National Food Showdown, and she has a special project that she's going to be talking about later on. And we have, and I'm very happy to meet both of you. I see both of you on television. We have couple Rolando Laudico and Jackie Juarez Laudico, who fell in love with the kitchen and then fell in love in the kitchen. They run Bistro Filipino, Chef Laudico Culinary Services, Be Fast, and Casa Filipino. Okay, we're meeting the Laudicos for the first time. We've heard so much about you, and I've been in one of your restaurants. But tell me about this love affair in the kitchen.
Wow, medyo matagal na yon. It started way back in college, actually. Our first date was I actually fetched her very early in the morning. And then she was like wondering, why are you fetching me at this time? Mga 7 a.m. Sabi ko, alam mo, basta, surprise. And you know where I brought her
where?
At 7 a.m.? Farmer's Market.
To
buy food. Because in my family, ako yung namamalengke.
Okay. So that's one quality that we must now look for in men.
Yes.
People who go to the market.
Yes. Kailangan marunong mamalengke and you know how to cook.
Okay. Yeah. And it worked, obviously, because you're now together and you run a very successful groups of restaurants. So how was it for you? Was that what attracted you to him? He was a...
Yeah, actually,
a potential cook or just going to the market?
It opened a different side of him because as classmates, we see him as a different person in school. He has this band, he sings in a band, and he drives his noisy car. So when he brought me to the market and cooks, I go, oh, there's a domesticated side to this guy. Oh,
but maybe he was also trying to test you whether you had any sense of what the different kinds of vegetables were. Was that
actually
your test?
Actually, that you are correct. I wanted to test her.
Yes.
Kung hindi siya maarte.
Oo.
Kasi if she's maarte, dadalhin ko sa palengke.
Oo.
Of course, she's like, ooh, ganun. Eh, hindi. Yeah. She actually loved it.
And then
I cooked for her like 4 or 5 dishes.
Wow, that was really sweet. Yeah. That's one way people must pick up from you on how to do it. Jessie, you've been around for a long, long time, and I always have you every other Christmas here.
Yes.
And you got started because the man of your father. Or your tradition in the family.
Yeah, got started because of my aunt, actually.
Ah, the aunt,
yeah.
Okay.
My aunt who introduced me to cooking and baking. Mm-hmm. Yes.
And so. Cooking and baking, and how old were you, or how?
I'm say it started so young because everybody cooks in the family. Mm-hmm. My grandmother, my mother, and my aunt who took care of me since I was 9. Mm-hmm. They all cook very well.
Oh.
So when I was like taken from my parents to be with them, the more I was exposed to more cooking because my aunt just loves to cook for the family.
Oh. And Myrna too.
12 family? Children. I'm number 12, and you know, growing up with a nanny who eventually became the mayordoma, and every meal, a catering, if you when you think about it, it was almost...
That's what got you interested.
Really? Yeah. it's almost obvious that, you'd end up in the kitchen because I literally grew up in the kitchen.
No, but this says something about keeping the secrets, the recipes in the family that eventually you just enjoy as a family on special occasions, but the probability of being a successful restaurateur. And was the family also interested in good food? Or ikaw lang?
Oh, yes. We all went to restaurants, taste new things. My mom would... cook as well. She would actually Jakwento mo, you go to from province to province, di ba?
Because my dad was in the military, and so I grew up going around Visayas and Mindanao. So I grew up tasting the different regional specialties and actually look forward, oy, pupunta tayong Davao, there's tuna. And also, in the province, in the municipality where I grew up, our house was a big one in front of the plaza. And we host all sorts of parties there for the town. Like, for example, the Last Supper of the Apostles. It's in our house.
And I've attended one of those. very, very interesting.
The San Jose. Yeah, we also have that. So.
Similar. My parents were from Batangas, and every year, my father would be the head of the festivities for the annual fiesta. Mm-hmm. And it's an open house.
Yes.
And so everyone's cooking the whole day. I've never, you know, I mean, I could actually play inside the calderos at the time, because then they would be preparing for big batches each time. And we're lucky in the sense that up to now, you know, we continue to enjoy these recipes through my yaya, who's, you know, taken on most of the traditions of cooking at home. And so this really is where it all comes from.
All of you have a family that loves food and likes to cook and does it well.
And are lucky enough to eat well.
Yeah.
I mean, not expensively, but, you know, have developed a palate or, you know, a taste for good flavors and good flavors.
Yeah, but now you have a lot of cooking and food shows on television here and abroad, and we watch them here. And there are many culinary schools that have cropped up. I mean, international brands of cooking schools, they are all here. Is that trying to take away from the simplicity of what you have had as children growing up in a family? Or you're now looking at a generation who will study the science of cooking? Is this something that you think is going to change the way we
definitely
bring the taste of our food?
Yes, definitely, because now as you can see, diners are more sophisticated. They really know what good food is all about, and I'm glad, because even young children nowadays are really so interested about cooking. As you can see, as you mentioned, a lot of television shows about cooking are catering not only to the mature audience, but even children.
Yes, yes.
And so it's good, because at an early age, their palates are trained to enjoy good food.
What it brings. You are, I see you on TV.
Yes.
And what is that experience all about? Tell us about it.
Well, yes, I'm a judge in Junior Master Chef. And every day that I see these kids, parang I see myself, because I started also cooking young, mga 7. Tumutulong na ako sa kitchen. I see them now. Parang sasabi ko sa sarili ko, I can never do what they're doing right now. Because information talaga helps a lot. I mean, regardless if it's TV or culinary schools. Kasi nung time namin, hindi pa uso culinary schools dito sa Manila. Yeah. There's zero. I mean, it's just probably yung mga sila... Maya Kitchen, siguro.
Maya Kitchen, that's
right. Sylvia Reynoso, mga ganun. But a really formal culinary school wasn't existing during our time. Mm-hmm. But now, grabe, it's everywhere. So no. I think the education, the information, and of course, internet. We have internet now. Mm-hmm. We can easily get a recipe, whatever it is. It changes the ball game. But for me, I think what's important is to still keep the tradition, the flavors of what makes Filipino food, food. And I think the information, the education, parang naging enhancement, alam mo, parang it makes it, kumbaga, more delicious.
Yeah.
More,
you know, when I was newly married, I had to cook. I had to show my children I knew how to cook. So I went to a cooking class for about 3 months. And true enough, you learn. But that was the time that wala pa ngang maraming cooking classes, di ba? Is going through a formal school better than going to an intimate school, or learning it from your mom, your yaya, and somebody?
At the end of the day, behind a great chef is a mom.
Yes, I like
that.
No, really. And you know, I organize an annual event called the National Food Showdown, and we go all around the country. Mm-hmm. And what this exercise really does for us is to bring out an awareness and interest in preparing our food nicely, you know, and taking the pains to, you know, to look into how you can make the food look good as well as taste good. Mm-hmm. Believe me, Tina, this was not existent before.
Yeah, I know.
So this is this little awareness alone.
But the competition is does it give it a different kind of a?
It's very healthy
dimension. The competition, like you have your junior master chefs. These are children who's being made to cook something out of a balut.
Yes,
and then they will create all of their exciting dishes. Does it help the process of learning how to be a good cook, or does it push a little button there that, in other words, my question for you, I just preface that, are you competing, chefs, are you competing amongst yourselves on what kind of dishes that you put out and what has become a bestseller or what has become the talk of the town? Meron bang ganung silent competition?
Well, you know, really, to be honest, you know, they are my family as well. I've known them for so long, and we look up to them. These are chefs na are inspiration for us.
These are icons and veterans. Your old dear and institutions.
You know, Chef Jessie.
Oh, hindi kami ganong katanda.
The euphemism.
No,
because nauna lang sila ng konti.
Pero we idolize them and we see na what they're doing, and we try to emulate that, and we try to like parang I want to be like her, and continue
then their efforts.
Nice. You know, so competition is real or is subdued, or
it makes we compete with each other in cooking competitions, but it's a friendly.
They've been competing since young.
It's a friendly competition. No. Of course, I beat Jessie all the time.
Iba yung mga chefs on parade dati.
But we are a very small circle.
Yeah, you are.
And we are, I mean, a lot of us are friends, and we all hope to stay as friends because
But you think the kind of foods that have come out as a result of your creativity and your resourcefulness, has it, what kind of a generation of Filipinos are you? I don't know if you're creating.
Uh-huh.
I know that my children are foodies. Anywhere we go in the world, they know where to go, what to eat, and they can describe what it is.
Okay, as my objectives, at least, is to make Filipino cuisine known to our own countrymen and our young, because believe me, Tina, a lot of our young people, or the young generation now, don't know what Filipino cuisine is all about. I've had to do food festivals in hotels, and it's like, I mean, it's so strange to be doing a food festival, a Filipino food festival in your own country.
Yeah.
Okay,
so regional, may regional twist.
But also, you know, to let our people know, old as well as young, what our food is all about, and to appreciate what we have.
Yes.
Because and I've nothing against Italian restaurants, French restaurants, Asian, Thai, Chinese, Japanese, but I'm so happy to see quite a few Filipino restaurants, and even as I am not purely Filipino in my theme, and as well as Jessie, we try to inject, a lot of Filipino touches.
She has variations of the adobo on different
adobo
kinds.
And I introduced the alugbati, which has become so popular in the restaurant. Sabi nga nila noon, they don't look at alugbati now. I mean, everybody's using it.
Yeah.
So things like this. And even though I became known in the circle as a French restaurant, but if you look closely in my menu, you can see adobo.
Yeah.
You've tried some of them, actually. And I've also done food promotions here and abroad. And we've authored the Culinaria book, which I am very happy I became part of that. And, you know, true to what Myrna said, we want Filipino food known in the world.
Okay.
So,
that's in the public setting. What about the home? This is something
lalo na.
Yung sa bahay, yung ano ba ang pinapakain natin sa bahay ngayon, ano? When we return, we talk about Filipino Christmas dishes and tips for cooking this busy season. You're watching Talkback.
person. Right.